You should have done it because he would have been, you know, who gives a fuck? You went by disqualification, who gives a fuck? You went by disqualification.
But Robert, you have to experience things. You have to prepare in training camp, maybe in your career, for every situation.
Hey, right now, there would probably be a lot of shit talking to him and about him. But who gives a fuck? He would be the fucking IPF, WBC, WBA, IPA,
right.
Champion of the world.
Maybe Lemieux.
Champion of the world. And Triple G would have a loss in his fucking record.
You're talking about when he was on his knee and Triple G hit him?
Yeah.
Now, how does that happen in a fight? Because I see a lot of it in fights where fighters are down and someone... It's just the adrenaline?
It's just
the instinct?
Yes, but you're not supposed to. That's the first thing they tell you in the locker room. This is your first and last warning. If you hit your opponent when he's down, it's going to cost you.
So Lemieux should have sold it.
Just if he would have just gone out and he can't continue, he would have won that fucking fight by disqualification. Yeah. But check this out. HBO, all those guys from HBO, those guys that like to say, what's his name?
Max Kellerman.
They're good.
Jim Lampley.
They're good, bro. The motherfuckers, they didn't even mention, you know, he should have done this, you know. If they want to have somebody, they've done a great job with fucking Triple G.
The only one that said something
Roy Jones. Yeah, Roy Jones,
because he's a fighter.
Roy Jones. Because that happened to Roy Jones when he fought,
Montel Griffin.
Montel Griffin, yeah, same thing. And what happened? Roy Jones lost. He lost because he hit his opponent when he was on the floor, and that guy was out. You know, supposedly he was out. So that was a loss for Roy Jones. Then they got a rematch. But wasn't it good for Montel? At least he's got one win over
Montel
Roy Jones.
Montel is a really cool dude. He works with kids in Chicago.
And I traveled with him.
He's a very short guy. The shortest light heavyweight ever.
I traveled
he's
with
like
him.
He's like Broner's height.
We traveled together.
Yeah.
Actually, our first international was together against Germany.
He's cool.
Yeah, he's fucking cool.
You know, TV,
but he's smart. You see, he's intelligent. If you get hit when you're down, sell it. Lemieux, what were you thinking? You could have been undisputed.
And I would have been happy. You know why? I would have been happy because I seen fucking Triple G with fucking Donald Trump.
What was that all about?
In the fucking locker room.
You guys got mad at him?
What was that?
Maybe,
a lot of people were mad.
Yeah, but he doesn't control who comes in the locker
room. So I could have said, sorry, I can't.
He's an immigrant.
I can't shake. He's an immigrant too.
Maybe Donald Trump came to say, you gotta leave.
He kissed him twice, like hug, whatever. I would have said, sorry, I can't shake your hand. I would have done that.
What?
It's like, I don't know, there's a video, I don't know if somebody has seen it, but there's like, guys that went to war, or the Navy, or one of those, you know, they're going by, getting awards, getting medals from different people, from the, you know, like the president, the vice president, all that. And then one of them goes by Barack Obama and leaves Barack Obama with
Why?
Like that. And because he wasn't up for Barack Obama. He probably didn't vote for him. He's got all the right to say, I don't want to shake your hand. He walks by Barack Obama.
To be honest with you.
Okay, and Obama was like this, and this guy just walked to the next guy.
It's disrespectful, but it's what he believes.
It is disrespectful, but that's his belief. So if Triple G is too nice, I think it was because he's just too nice and respect. But nah, this guy, what everything he's saying about immigrants, he doesn't deserve to be respected by another immigrant. Because he's an immigrant too. He's got a lot of relatives that are immigrants. He's got, okay, he wants all the Mexicans to cheer him on, right?
Yep.
Mexican style. Well, look at everything that what's his name saying about Mexicans. That we're fucking, you know, that he wants to kick us 12 million people out of the United States. He wants to build a wall. You know, he's talking bad, mad shit. And he hugs him and kisses him like, I would have said, sorry, but nope, I'm not going to shake your hand, I'm not going to hug you. I would have.
You've done it before, I've seen you do it.
I think he would have.
I saw a fighter once try to shake your hand after a fight, and you said, sorry, I don't shake your hand.
Right, bro. Why am I going to be faking? Oh,
you're not fake, you keep it real.
Sorry. Trainer do it.
Who? Oh, yeah, you also did it to that trainer. There was a trainer who was fake talking shit about you, and then he tried to shake your hand.
Oh, yeah. Why am I going to shake his hand?
Yeah, because he was talking shit.
Fucking talking shit, and I'm like, he's a fucking drunk and this and
you
that.
You didn't shake his hand?
All his fighters are fucking...
And he got mad at you?
All his fighters are fucking punching bags. And then he sees me and, how you doing, Robert? I ain't gonna shake your hand, my man. The fuck out of here, right?
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, @EllieSekpak.